Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Pokémon UNITE on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Pokémon UNITE and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Pokémon UNITE. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to start we have to launch our favorite internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you're able to discover on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, because I provided a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up there on our own website of Usitility, at which we get in-depth information on the way to download and install Pokémon UNITE on personal computer. We search lower a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will load to play Pokémon UNITE on the PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of advantages of running that emulator. So we are ready to proceed to download the Pokémon UNITE by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on it. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, then we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We click yes. I minimize the internet browser to view the installation software much better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of two choices, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path genuinely does. We only click it, and then we note that we display here the path where your emulator is going to be set up. If we prefer to change for better this folder, we have to click on this browse button, and we choose another directory and install the emulator precisely where we prefer. To keep it simple, just leave it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I pick install. Great, the install starts and it's going to continue in the download of those MB that happens to be shown on our screen. When you save it on your hard drive, it could be a little bit more or less MB. The data transfer rate might go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your type of access to the web and according to the performance of the emulator web servers. Today they are working incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be launched on autopilot. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will fill up so when it attains the finish, the emulator can be started for the very first time. Believe it or not, the emulator was already started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can see now, it created two software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is definitely the one we are interested in. Anytime we are planning to run Pokémon UNITE on the laptop or computer, we twice click on this particular software icon and consequently use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we conduct the next phase? That is a requirement, and that's to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. There we have got to sign in. Right now, as soon as we're there, we must definitely perform this next phase that is imperative. So we click on Sign In. Presently it shows Checking Info. It may occasionally get stuck in Checking Info, additionally it fails to progress. In that case, you could attempt to log in after a couple of hours and it may quite likely be sorted out. At this time we're going to type in our login name and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For example, you can use the same email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I will insert my information and I'll revisit after I have completed it. Voila! Info inserted. Below is Google welcoming us and providing us their tools. We can approve all of them by clicking on I agree. Following that, it makes it possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected and this will build a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can make use of this feature if you prefer. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched automatically and instantly. To set up the video game, we must browse the Android emulator desktop by clicking on this icon marked green colored. At this point that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator, we can see that we now have right here the install app option. we click or double-click on that button. On this page we have got the video game. How about we click on now on the install choice that I am just showing now in green color. This action will commence the setup. Presently it should install the game app, it could take quite some time or it may be very fast. This all depends on the internet access. It's actually finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing that option that I am emphasizing in green, that allows you to start Pokémon UNITE for the very first time. I am presently on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are about to mouse click on that brand new Pokémon UNITE software icon which has been generated. That video game is started for the first time. So there we get it, I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume of this emulator. It is right here, we have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the max, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This one is actually the very first one, we mouse click on this particular icon which I am identifying in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In the case that we wish to have fun with the video game using all the screen, we hit this particular game icon. So we would probably by now be experiencing the video game in 100% screen setting. To get out of the complete screen setting, hit the F11 key. And we might by now end up being in normal display screen setting. At this point, I am choosing to explain you the computer keyboard mapping that is actually rather enjoyable. That strategy we will likely be able to use the game much more easily. The very first task is to press this computer keyboard icon. It's now time to get the required controls. I most certainly will put the normal settings, however if you want to change it, you can also do it with no problem. As you can observe, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it happens that your emulator is started in the improper language, for instance, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to place it in the correct language we go there to the cogwheel. So right here within many other configurations, we mouse click on the language drop-down. We may very well select the language we prefer, German, Chinese, etc. Once the language is selected, we would save, the emulator will reboot, along with the video game, next time we start it, will as well be in the picked language. Right now, there's another information that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will get an email telling that a completely new device has been connected to our Google account. It should check with us if we are the people who have associated with that device. Indeed, we must not get worried, simply because the emulator is acting as a Google Android tablet or smartphone. So you can find which electronic device is currently being emulated. We arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model selection. And right here we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for our training. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, specifically that everyone thought it was useful. If so, give it a great like, subscribe to our channel, and any comments, concerns or ideas, let them in the comment area down below. You also can leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams from time to time, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of those instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the next videos. Bye!